Good morning, I'm Paige Davidson, the worship leader for Ignite at PVUMC. I'd like to welcome you all to this time of worship together. We thank God for bringing us together, unique people from diverse backgrounds, identities, needs, and dreams. As we prepare our hearts for worship, I want to share a verse written in the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 1, verse 3. The writer says, "Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that openly profess his name. And do not forget to do good and share with others, for with such sacrifices God is pleased." I love and need this reminder that our offering of praise to our God Most High, what we're doing right now, also extends into the life we live later in the week, the extension of our love through doing good and sharing with others. If you haven't already, please take a moment during the service to click the connection card link at the top of the screen to let us know you're here. And if you'd like to share a prayer request with a live person, you can do so privately and confidentially by clicking the prayer request link at the bottom of the screen. Thank you for joining us this morning.
I'm Bethany Taylor, and I invite you to join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we know that so often we focus on what we do not have, rather than giving thanks for the many blessings that you have so generously bestowed upon us. Thank you for your compassion and for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who showed us what it meant to walk in faith. Shape our hearts, minds, and souls that we may give our love, grace, compassion, kindness, and charity as freely as you do. Help us to cultivate a generosity of spirit that reflects your own. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen.
sing the almighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing seas abroad and built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom that ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at God's command, and all the stars obey. I sing the goodness of the Lord, who filled the earth with food, who formed the creatures through the word, and then pronounced them good. Lord, how thy wonders are displayed, where'er I turn my eye. If I survey the ground I tread, or gaze upon the sky, there's not a plant or flower below but makes thy glories known. And clouds arise and tempests flow by order from thy throne, while all that borrows life from thee is ever in thy care. And everywhere that we can be, thou God art present there.
Hello, friends. Good morning. I'm so happy you're starting your day with us here. Have any of you ever seen a giant sequoia tree? Maybe you've seen one in a picture, or you learned about them in school. Maybe you've even visited the Sequoia National Park or Yosemite to see them in person, like my sister and her family did a couple summers ago. These sequoia trees are pretty remarkable. The tallest sequoia is 316 feet tall. The widest is 31.4 feet. The biggest weighs about 642 tons. That's about 107 elephants. And it's estimated they can live to be 3,000 years old. The giant sequoia forest where these trees grow is approximately 48,000 acres, which is just about the size of Cleveland, Ohio. These towering trees seem almost invincible, but even they need care. These trees get so big because they live for a very long time and grow quickly. They need lots of water, and thankfully, they get that from the snow as it melts each spring. They need soil that can drain well, and rich soil and sunlight for their seedlings to grow. It's amazing how many things have to go just right for these trees to thrive. But once they do, we can all enjoy their beauty. The same way these giant sequoia trees need nurturing to grow, so does our church. When we work together to share our talents, special gifts, money, and prayers, something as small as this sequoia seed can grow into this. Let's pray. Dear God, help us plant the seeds for the ministry of PVUMC to grow and care for our community. Amen.
Oh, Hello, I am Steve Shankman, chairperson of the Generosity Ministry team. John Colwell, who is the vice chairman, and I will take a few minutes to kick off the 2021 Generosity Campaign, in which More Than Enough is the theme. But first, we want to thank you for your ongoing generosity. Our year-to-date pledge contributions are up 10% versus our budget. That is incredible given the big shifts in our ministries this past year, like switching to online worship caused by the COVID-19 virus. We also want to thank our sustaining donors who have set up their ongoing contributions to PVUMC. John?
Hello, my name is John Colwell. According to Scripture, God has the power to provide you with more than enough of every kind of grace. The Apostle Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians 9, "You will be made rich in every way." As far as we know, Paul had no real estate holdings, no life insurance policy, and no retirement plan. There are good reasons for most of us to have things like that. But Paul challenges us to rethink how we define rich and more than enough. God's wisdom truly does open new kinds of freedom, contentment, and satisfaction before us. As Steve mentioned previously, a series of three sermons entitled More Than Enough will be followed by 2 weeks of Commitment Sundays, where you will have the opportunity to make your pledge for the upcoming fiscal year. You will also receive a weekly Grow, Pray, and Study guide each week during the series, which contains scripture readings and family activities that support the sermons. If you use email, you will receive your guide electronically each week of the series. If you do not have an email address registered at the church, you'll receive three guides in a single postal mailing. Again, thank you for your continued support and generosity for the programs and missions at Paradise Valley United Methodist Church.
Good morning. I'm Martha Rennie, a member here at PVUMC. Our scripture reading today is from the Psalms. Praise the Lord. Happy are those who fear the Lord, who greatly delight in his commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches are in their houses, and their righteousness endures forever. They rise in the darkness as a light for the upright. They are gracious, merciful, and righteous. It is well with those who deal generously in land, who conduct their affairs with justice. For the righteous will never be moved. They will be remembered forever. They are not afraid of evil tidings. Their hearts are firm, secure in the Lord. Their hearts are steady. They will not be afraid. In the end, they will look in triumph on their foes. They have distributed freely. They have given to the poor. Their righteousness endures forever. Their horn is exalted in honor. The wicked see it and are angry. They gnash their teeth and melt away. The desire of the wicked comes to nothing. Thanks be to God.
Hello, and thank you for joining us for our worship and for this message. I'm Dave Summers, one of the pastors here at Paradise Valley UMC. You know, issues of money are prominent and forefront in our minds. The Dow jumps around and can be a roller coaster sometimes. The pandemic has certainly brought unemployment, rising eviction rates. Some of you I know carry very serious financial worry in your lives. It's a precarious time. And there's a bigger issue for us. All of us have been fed a lie. Some of us know this, some of us suspect it, and some of us hate to face it. But we're bombarded with messages about what will make us happy. And we're told constantly it is for sale. Every time you log on to Facebook or a favorite website or some other social media ads are targeted just to you. Do you ever worry that God knows your secret desires? Well, the internet retailers are right behind God. Television and radio messages always feed our desire to want to own more, to buy products that will make you look better, feel healthier, look sexier, and so on. You cannot escape these messages. I want to thank the Church of the Resurrection and Pastor Adam Hamilton for some of the thoughts that we're going to share these next three Sundays. You know, the Bible and our faith tradition offers wisdom that can help and can shape our financial lies and help us to see the lie for what it is. Psalm 112 that we read today talks about this. Happy are those who fear the Lord, who greatly delight in God's commandments. Their hearts are firm, secure in the Lord. Now, I know that talk about fearing God always sounds like, well, fear or judgment, about worry, not love. But it's really about much more. It's about a right response to God, about a sense of awe and wonder, respect for God. It's about a deep-seated love, a desire to do what God wants. Can you easily figure out God's directions and desires for you instead of just butting your head against it all the time? Here in the psalm, it says that God truly cares about our financial lives and how we handle them. Think of this analogy. Who do you admire? Who would you like to learn from? For me, I play guitar. What if I had a chance to spend a couple of hours taking a guitar lesson from Eric Clapton, getting tips about how to play better? Would I take that? You bet I would. Maybe you like to cook. What if you had a chance to spend an afternoon in Rachel Ray's kitchen? Or if you like to golf, what if you could play 18 holes with Tiger Woods? If Tiger were to offer you some instructions, maybe some tips on how to improve your golf swing, would you try it? Of course you would. And what about a conversation with God? What if you had a chance to talk with God about what makes life really work? That's what a passage like this is saying to us. It's saying, if you fear the Lord, you have nothing else to fear in this life. And that's wisdom for us. Jesus, you know, talks often about money because humans, well, we struggle with it. He says, we cannot serve both God and money. He also says, your life does not consist in the abundance of your possessions. But messages that we hear constantly tell us that your life does consist in the abundance of your possessions and that you don't have enough. That actually sounds to me a bit like the psalm that we read, where it says, the wicked see and are angry. They gnash their teeth and they melt away. The wicked to me sounds like people who are just stressed out, who are angry and not fulfilled. But Jesus always reminds us that you have more than enough. Psalm 112 talks about a path of wisdom versus the path of fools. And I thought about this as I was reading recently Thomas Stanley, a man who has studied wealth and millionaires for a long time. He wrote a book called The Millionaire Next Door. He says these are people who are successful economically because they think differently. He pointed out that the average millionaire is someone who buys their clothes at Dillard's or JCPenney's, probably spends only $400 on a suit. These are people, he said, who are more likely to drive a Ford and Toyota, not a BMW. They are not at all focused on consuming or living up to some flashy image. It reminds me of a verse from the book of Proverbs that says, some pretend to be rich, but they have nothing, while others pretend to be poor, but they have great riches. Well, we will talk more about this research from Thomas Stanley in the next couple of weeks. The path of wisdom, it says here, has two other elements that help our faith and our financial practices. One is the way of generosity, what we learn and live in our lives in our giving habits. The Bible does talk about giving in many ways. For instance, you see a need, you respond to it. Psalm 112 said that those on the path of blessedness have distributed freely. They have given to the poor. We also learn to give regularly and faithfully. We learn to give to God first, which really builds our attachment and our trust in God, not in money. You know, throughout the last year, we talked about making a 1% increase in your giving, about raising your giving to the church by 1% of your total income. I still think that's a worthy goal for us all. Paul, who was an early missionary, told the church in Corinth, he said, God can provide you with more than enough. Your lives will be enriched in every way. And that's really wisdom for all of us. When you trust God will give you more than enough, then your life is well lived. Paul knew there were lots of ways to be rich. This is not a guarantee, necessarily, of financial wealth, but about how we can be rich in faith, in hope, in loving relationships, and knowing that God understands and provides for what we most need. Second, Paul knew that our giving expresses a gratitude for all of the gifts that we have received. How important this is. Ben Stein, the actor, comedian, and economist, said it this way, I cannot tell you anything that in a few minutes will tell you how to be rich, but I can tell you how to feel rich, which is far better. Be grateful. It's the only totally reliable get-rich-quick scheme. Robert Emmons has conducted a great deal of gratitude research. It's an emerging science right now. And he's looked at things like the relationship of happiness and our health to how grateful we are. He has some fascinating research findings. He found that grateful people were 25% happier than other participants in his studies. The challenge for us is that gratitude is not always recognized much here in the U.S. There are other emotions like anger or fear or anxiety that seem much more common these days that are hyper-recognized. But Emmons found that grateful people are less likely to base their happiness on material possessions. They're less envious of others. They're less likely to measure success in terms of material gain. Again, to me, this sounds more like that psalm we read about the path of blessedness. This path of blessedness and wisdom tells us what matters in life, that there are other ways to be rich. There's a famous study of men who attended Harvard University. It's called the W.T. Grant Study. And they tracked these graduates over a period of time. For nearly 75 years, they studied 268 men who had attended Harvard. And they looked at many issues around their lives, their success and their accomplishments. And the conclusion was striking. What really matters in life, it turns out, are your relationships. If you have few, if people don't like you, if you have no one left with you at the end, you're poorer than you can imagine. This is one of the ways, I think, that God made us for this path of blessedness. Live into it, and you will find that you have more than enough. This is a hard and challenging time for us, financially, health-wise, for our nation and our world. But God cares greatly how we live. God does not want us to live by fear, fear that we will be alone, fear that we won't have enough, fears about how we will face the future. Let's not be like those who are described in that psalm, who are so anxious, so unhappy that they gnash their teeth and melt away. God wants so much more for us. In the next weeks, we will talk about some financial habits that will help us to keep on this path of wisdom and blessedness and be able to live as God intends for us. I invite you to pray for me for how we can take some more steps on this path. God, as I pray and finish up this message, I hope that there's some part of this sermon that will speak to each one listening today about living into your desires, O God, and into your wisdom for us. Sometimes we are people who just struggle with generosity, but God, you tell us not to be afraid. Or if we are people who struggle with relationships, help us, God, to build them and to value them. If we struggle in trusting you, God, help us to take that step of faith today, knowing that your hand is in ours, that you lead us, and that you love us and will always guide us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
We are reminded in 2 Corinthians 9, verse 8, that God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. You cannot outgive God, and this is one great reason why we give. The work of the church is important to God. Thank you to all of you who already give regularly. If you would like to give to PVUMC today, there is a giving tab on your screen to click on, or you can go to the website, pvumc.org, and find the giving tab, or you can mail a check to the church. Let us pray. God, your generosity is beyond our understanding. We are so grateful for your compassion, forgiveness, and blessings in our lives. Take our offering today and use it for your good and for your glory. In Christ we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Will you pray with me? Holy God, we are 3 full weeks into January, and many of us already feel like it's been a year. We have seen a vast increase in deaths due to the pandemic, an insurrection on the nation's capital, and the anxiety of increased violence weighs heavily on our hearts. God, give us rest. Breathe into us your presence, your Holy Spirit. May it energize us, rejuvenate us, and make us agents of your love and peace. As this nation inaugurated a new president and vice president, we pray for them and all of our nation's leaders. May you grant them wisdom and discernment that they may lead our nation and our people with empathy, compassion, and grace. We are reminded that there has been a divide between what God wants for his people and what is reality. Lord, make us repairers of divisions. Grant us wisdom and courage until the poor are lifted, the sick are healed, children are protected, and civil and human rights are never neglected. Grant us wisdom for the facing of the coming days until love and justice are never rejected. Grant us wisdom and courage in the coming days, weeks, and months until together we do all we can do to ensure there is racial justice, economic justice, healthcare justice, disability justice, justice for the poor, the homeless, and immigrants. Grant us wisdom and courage until we study war no more and peace with justice becomes the way we live. As we begin our generosity campaign for this next year today, let us remember all of the blessings you have bestowed on us. Help us to see your children in need throughout the world and to understand all that we are called to do to help them. Lead us, Lord, in our giving so that as individuals and a faith community, we understand that we have been blessed so that we may be a blessing to others. Let us remember that our giving expresses gratitude for all that you have given us. Help each of us to prayerfully consider what we will pledge so that your good work may be done through us this coming year. We ask all of these things in the blessed name of Jesus, and we pray now as he has taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
King of creation.
As we wrap up our service, I've got three announcements you'll want to hear. First, PVUMC families are invited to a virtual Valentine's Day party this Wednesday night, February 3rd, from 6:30 to 7. Come enjoy crafts, candy, and Christian fellowship. They still have some party kits available, so if you want to attend, contact Kristen at kristen@pvumc.org. And all are invited to drive through PVUMC for donuts and coffee on Sunday, February 14th, from 8 to 10:30 a.m. Enjoy free iced coffee, water, juice, and donuts, and a Valentine's Day goodie bag for the kids. And finally, we are sad to announce that today is our interim youth minister, Rachel Smith's last day. But we wish her well as she sets out on a new adventure. Please be sure to reach out to her with your well wishes. We'll miss you, Rachel.
Thank you again for joining us for our worship today. We're grateful to have you with us for this online time together. And now let's receive this dismissal. Now may the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of the Christ. And the blessings of God Almighty, our Creator, the Christ, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. We will look forward to seeing you here with us for worship next week.